Hello and welcome all. In this video, I will show you how to log in Moodle, create courses and register students. On your computer screen, open a browser. Type the URL SPPU Moodle .unipune.ac.in. The Moodle screen will appear with login window. You have to use login credentials used in HR administration. HR administration is the one which is here. Human Resource Management System, where you can reach from our website of Savitri Bai Phule, Pune University. Whatever credentials you use here are the same credentials you have to use for Moodle. That's why the username is your employee number and your password. Now we log in. After login, you may see a different courses, a different page showing courses that you have created earlier. In order to see the list of departments, you have to click on Site Home. You will see all departments. Choose your department. Now I will choose Miscellaneous Department. In this department, I want to create a new course, so click on Add a New Course. Now fill up all the essential things. Let me give the name of the course, Test Moodle. A short name could be TM. Course category is this. Course start date is say 13 February, whatever it is, and maybe 12 instead of February. I can say let it be April, and of course not 2021 but 2020. You can have whatever dates which are the correct dates, you can put it here. Then it requires some description for the sake of students. Here it will be Testing Moodle. Whatever description you give will appear and students will be able to see. From here, just save and display. Now your course page is created. It already shows some topics and so on. And there are announcements which you can make. So you can just play with it and create whatever course material or course that you want students to know information from this particular page. To allow registration by students to this course, there are two ways. One by registration key and other by creating QR code. We will show how to create the QR code for registration. For registration facilitation on the screen displaying course, on the left hand side we have participants. So click on participants. Right now you are the only person who is registered. Now, for knowing what are the possibilities of different type of registration, click on this gear symbol. There are various methods and options. Choose enrollment method. Now, we want self-enrollment by students, and therefore, we would like to activate it by clicking on the eye. So eye opens up That means it is now activated. We'll again click the gear symbol. Now self-enrollment page is in front of us, which we can fill up. In this case, elementary key is the one which you may provide in case you want registration by key, but we are going to create the QR code. Enrollment duration, you can have whatever days you want. Notify before enrollment expires. Notification threshold, 1 day, and so on. Start date, it says 12 February, and end date could be whatever you want. So all these things can be filled up. So if it is 12, maybe we can say instead of 12, okay, he can do up to say 1 week. So up to 19th of February, the person is able to register. No question of unenrolling. You can also set maximum enrolled users and so on. If you want a custom welcome message, it will be shown here. However, with this you can go save changes and self-enrollment is now activated. In order to create the QR code, we go back to the course page, which is this one. We are given name TM, so we go there. On the course page, again click on the gear symbol and then click on turn editing on. As you can see, it creates one more button called add a block. Now if you are on a simple laptop, this add a block may or may not appear on the screen because of the size of the screen. So you have to appropriately go downward and look for it. It always appears. Now click on add block. In this add block, go down, you will find QR code. Now you click on the QR code. The QR code for your course is now generated. You want this to be downloaded, so let the format be PNG, and in PNG format you will be able to download the QR code. Once this is done, the QR code can be printed on a page and you can display that page on notice board for students, saying what is your course number, who is teaching and so on. And then students, using their mobile, they can scan this. And if they, when they scan, they will automatically register on your course. So this is the method of registration. We go back, turn editing off. And now we would like to log out. This is the profile button. This is actually a human face which should appear. If you provide your face, it will appear here in the profile. So we click on the face, it gives you option logout, you log out. So this ends the first video.